concerned about the environment?
Yeah, to some extent.
Yes. Yeah, actually.
Yes.
Yeah, we are very, very concerned.
Do you know what's this label about? Have you seen it before?
Yeah, I've seen it before.
No, I haven't seen that before.
Green label. I see them on like pressure fluid.
What do you know about this label?
I just seen it around.
Actually, nothing about it. Yeah, I know nothing. I see. Not much. Probably it's some like environmental friendly thing.
If I'm not wrong, it's like those. If the product is environmentally friendly, then like you have it on the like you'll be labeled with that the sign label thing.
The Singapore Green Label Scheme was first launched in May 1992 by the Singapore Environment Council and is used to certify products that are environmentally friendly. These products have to meet the standards set and to be assessed by an independent third party before they can attain the green label. There are many products in the market now that carry the green label, such as dishwashing liquid, liquid detergent, correction fluid, as well as cornware. There are also many other types of green labels in Singapore. Green labels and certifications for products, services, and responsibilities provide a certified green trust mark for consumers and businesses who wish to exercise environmental responsibility. In Singapore, the other common types of green labels include eco-office label, energy label, water efficiency, and Singapore green building product certifications. So now, let us look at the typical scene in the local supermarket. Cinderella walked into the supermarket and she wanted to look for the perfect present for her prince. When she was scanning through the shelves, she was shocked. Did she find a frog or did she find something else? She wondered, why are there so many green colored labels? I need to find the perfect green present for my prince. She is confused as she could not tell the differences in the labels and hence unable to make the right choice. The previous scenes portray the fact that there are more products claiming to be green on the shelves of store these days. However, do you know that those products claiming to be all natural and organic are likely to be committing the seven deadly sins? Wait, I'm not referring to sins like lust or greed, but rather the seven sins of greenwashing. One common sin is the sin of worshipping false labels, whereby consumers are being misled through the creation of false labels or certification-like images on their products. Another sin committed is the sin of fibbing, whereby companies make environmental claims that are simply false and misled consumers regarding the environmental practices of a company just in order to increase their sales and to gain profits at the expense of the green consumers. Therefore, to solve this problem, education is key. Educate campaigns and roadshows in schools, tertiary institutions and supermarkets in heartland malls are needed to increase consumer awareness of green label and to help them identify the differences to make informed choices. By gaining a better understanding of the significance of green labels, consumers will be able to better distinguish between the two and to prevent greenwashing from occurring. Through sovereignty, they will be able to exert pressure on companies to produce true green products. So now, Cinderella is able to make a choice and to choose a perfect green present for her darling prince. So that consumers know how green are green label products, we propose to establish different levels of green labels, namely gold, silver and bronze green label. The gold, silver and bronze certification will be given based on the various degree of impacts the product has made on the environment. Detailed criteria to achieve each green standard will be followed. More stringent requirements are to be met in order for a product to be promoted to higher green standard. For criteria that needs third-party certifications, companies will need to seek two external parties instead of one as currently done. This is to prevent any tampering of the system by uncredible third party. As consumers are now becoming more and more environmentally conscious, a stricter standard for a green label might cause companies to face a decline in sales. On the other hand, for companies who wish to fully commit in being environmentally friendly, the cost of being green is never low. The cost involved to achieve even higher green standard will result in companies making a decision between two choices. First, to internalize the incremental cost, or two, to pass it down to the consumers. Companies being profit-driven might be hesitant in accepting the proposed scheme. However, the establishment of stricter standards for green label is essential to protect the consumer interest in the long run. So, do you now know what is green label?